Ladies and gentlemen, today I'm going to give you five reasons why you should sell your C7 for a brand new C8 Corvette. Everyone, and welcome back to Brink of Speed. As you can see, I am at my favorite spot, this giant distribution center. It's such an amazing thing to have all this space to myself. And before we get into today's episode, please hit that red subscribe button and the bell for notifications when my new content comes out. And also, please hit that thumbs up button so that this video gets shared all over and helps support the channel. All right, let's go ahead and get into the video. Oh, but wait, there's something in the frunk that I need to show you guys. Let's open this up. Well, what do you know? Look at that. A beautiful Brink of Speed logoed hoodie. And ladies and gentlemen, it's pretty much winter and it's getting cold. And if you'd love to help support the Brink of Speed community, go on my Brink of Speed store and purchase one of those comfy hoodies. They're super warm and I know you won't regret it. They are so comfortable. They wear well. I've had that thing for a year now and it still feels brand new. And I wear it all the time in the winter and the spring. So, and obviously in the fall. But anyway, let's go ahead and jump into the video. All of the information for my Brink of Speed store will be in the comment and the description down below. So obviously this video is all about why you should sell your C7 Corvette for a C8 Corvette. And I've got five reasons why. The number one reason that I'm gonna go over right now is that currently you can get a lot of money for your C7. They are up in the market, as you've seen on a video that I did last month talking about, for some reason, C7 values are way up. They're still up, maybe not as much as they were last month, but you can still get great value for your used C7. So here's the deal. If you are the type of person that is wanting a C8, but you just don't know if it's going to be better than the C7, I can answer that right away. It is better in every single way. There's not a single thing about that C8 that I feel is not superior to the C7. Now, obviously, we're comparing apples to apples here. I'm not talking about a Z06 or a ZR1. I'm talking about Stingray to Stingray. That C8 is far superior in every way than the C7 Stingray. So if you're the person that's on the fence saying, you know, should I trade up? Should I get the new C8 Corvette? And you're wanting to obviously trade in or sell your current C7 before you get that, then you need to do it now if you can go without having your C7 Corvette or having a Corvette period for a little while. That's another question that you have to ask yourself though. Are you gonna be able to do without a Corvette for maybe a year and a half? I don't know. I mean, it could be a while. But the other thing that you can throw in there if you don't have to have a brand new car is in the near future, the C8 prices are gonna come down, the used C8 prices. So I would say next year, maybe, I don't know, maybe January, February, you're probably gonna be looking at normal C8 prices. And when I say normal, I mean like you're gonna pay under what that car was MSRP or sticker because it's used. Right now, you're having to pay over what that car was sticker. So you may not have to wait very long. You could get rid of your C7 right now and make more money on it. And then beginning of next year, buy a used C8 and get something that's beautiful, gently used for less than it costs brand new. So that's number one. Sorry guys, it's getting a little bright out here. I know I'm in the shade, but my eyes are super sensitive. Number two, this is unlike any other Corvette. It's not the same as you going from a C6 to a C7 or a C5 to a C6. It's not the same. It's two completely different scenarios. Yes, the C7 was a huge, huge difference between it and the C6, but this is a massive, massive difference between the C7 and itself. So it's quite a bit different. If you're thinking, I don't know if the C8 is going to blow my mind. I don't know if it's gonna make me not care about getting rid of my C7. I'm here to tell you it is. It's gonna help you forget that C7 quickly. I owned a C7 Z06. Do I miss it? Not really. Every once in a while, when I'm, you know, driving around at high speed, 70, 80 miles an hour, whatever, I sometimes miss being able to punch the gas from that speed and still feel like it was ripping my head off. But that's a Z06. That's two totally different cars. If I would have owned a Stingray, I wouldn't be feeling that way at all, because this is faster than a Stingray anyway. But I don't miss my C7. I don't. And I'm gonna give you more reasons why, but I don't. And I know you won't, as long as you keep an open mind. I mean, go drive one. Go drive a C8. Go ride in a C8. You are gonna figure out very quickly that it is far superior to a C7. Okay, so number three is all about the road trip experience in this car. The reason why this car is superior over a C7 is because you have more cargo space. The C7 definitely had a lot in that back hatch area, but this has more because you have a trunk in the rear and you have the frunk in the front. So you can fit quite a bit of stuff in this car. And by the way, I'll put a link up here somewhere, it's either here or over here, to a video where my wife and I show you how much you can get in the frunk and the trunk of this car. But you can fit so much stuff in this C8. So let me just show you, here's the trunk. It's pretty large, can fit a lot back here. On top of that, the smoothness of this car on a road trip is second to none. It is like nothing you've ever felt, I don't think. I mean, unless you've owned a high-end Cadillac or high-end Mercedes or high-end Lincoln or something like that, where you've taken road trips and the ride was just like buttery smooth, and it was like you didn't feel exhausted or drained after driving. You felt like, wow, I still have energy. I don't feel beat up. The seats don't beat you up. It is the most amazing road trip car I've ever driven. I mean, the most amazing. So that's number three. I mean, that alone, I took some long trips in my C7, never as far as I went in my C8, but I took some good long trips in my C7. And don't get me wrong, it was smooth, but not anything compared to that. This feels like you're riding on a cloud. It's amazing. Phenomenal. By the way, so far, if you agree or disagree with anything that I've stated, leave it down in the comment section below. All right, we need to be in the car for this number four, number five also. But if you already drive a C7 automatic, then you're really gonna love the dual clutch that's in this C8. It's like an automatic on steroids. In my C7 Z06, don't get me wrong, that automatic was fantastic. It shifted really, really nicely most of the time, but it had its flaws. In it definitely did not shift as fast as I truly wanted it to in certain scenarios. So fast forward to this C8, this dual clutch is instant. It's like you can't even imagine how fast this thing shifts until you get in it, drive it, and feel it and experience it for yourself. But it is lightning fast on the shifts. And I'm about to show you. I mean, that right there, just barely accelerating, I'm already to fifth gear with super quick shifts. I'm gonna put it in sport mode though. I mean, you see that? From 0 to 75 like that, not even pushing it all the way up to high RPM range. And that was with me using the paddle shifters. But now, I'm gonna put it in competitive mode. And for those of you who have not seen a launch mode in this car, not only is the launch mode impressive, but it's gonna blow your mind at how fast this thing shifts in launch mode. I mean, it is unreal how fast it shifts in launch mode. All right, so check this out. Seconds wasn't even trying. I just stopped and did launch mode and got a 2.9 second 0 to 60. So that right there will show you how phenomenal this 8-speed dual clutch transmission is in this Corvette, in the C8. All right, so moving on to number five and the final reason why I believe you should sell your C7 for C8 Corvette, and that is that just overall on the full spectrum of all things being equal, these two cars are not equal. The C8 completely dominates it in every area. Number one, it's a smoother ride. It's way more comfortable than the C7. Number two, it has far superior grip because it is a mid-engine now. And a huge difference between front engine and mid-engine is weight transfer. For one thing, there is no weight in the rear of a C7 Corvette. All the weight is up front. So you got all this power and no way of putting it down without just burning up the tires if you're really wanting to get a hard launch. Whereas in the C8, all the weight is in the rear now and the weight transfer is perfect. So you get grip to the rear wheels like you've never had before. Not to mention that because it's a mid-engine, it handles so much better than the C7 Corvette. Now I'm coming from a Z07 Z06 with phenomenal handling. It was the best handling car I had ever driven until I drove this. Even if you're not gonna take this car to the track, you're still gonna have fun with it. You're still gonna take it around corners quickly. You're still gonna, you know, goof off in it and do things that most cars could not handle, and this car will not only handle it, it'll make it look easy. Now, if you are going to go to the track, even better. As you know, I've never taken this to the track yet and officially done laps with it, but I have driven a C8 at the track and pushed it really hard. And when I pushed it as hard as I could, I was able to push it much harder than my C7 Z06 for a couple of reasons, but one of the reasons was it gave me more confidence. this car literally pivots around your hips. It feels like anywhere you want to turn and go, it's ready to go there. And so that's really the fifth and final thoughts that I have towards why you shouldn't wait for any more time. If you're ready to upgrade, if you are salivating at getting yourself out of a C7 Corvette and into a C8 Corvette, don't wait. Now's the time. Now's when you can get the most money out of your C7, and it shouldn't be too much longer, like I said before, until the C8, the used C8 market has come down to a norm where you're able to buy them for quite a bit less than the MSRP was on them to start with. So, ladies and gentlemen, that's gonna do it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned a lot. I hope this helps you in your decision-making process for a new C8 Corvette. If you enjoyed it, again, support the channel by giving me a thumbs up. Help it, you know, get pushed out on YouTube by giving that thumbs up. Also, please hit that red subscribe button and the bell for notifications when my new content comes out. And I hope each and every one of you has a wonderful rest of your day. And I'll see you out on the road. We'll be right back.